This is the Fork Collector agenda. I ask both of you, you can respond whichever one goes first. We'll let Shelly first and then let Cindi. Do you feel the collector experience, our general work experience, is which is the most important? Do you feel the experience as a collector or as a work experience in a bank or do you feel that your experience is better than what the experience in the bank would be?
Given that
pitch 22.
Given that I have worked in the collector's office, there is such a wide variety of duties. There's the software to know how to do. There's always going to be little things that doesn't happen but once a year. Working in the office, I feel like I can provide a shoe in to the office and just take right over. I've worked closely with Grace Miles for these last 4 years, going on 5 now, and with my experience with her guidance, I wouldn't have a problem.
I feel that my experience in the bank gives me a better handle on management of people and the financial aspect of the business and what's going on. I guess I collected loan payments and now I collect tax payments, and those phone calls don't always deal with happy people, but at the end of the day you have to put a positive spin on it and try and help the customer or the taxpayer. It's all the same. My management, my banking experience, and I guess from what I said before, I've been a branch manager, a customer service manager, a loan assistant with no training. All of that, what I would say to my former boss was baptism by fire. I've done it and I succeeded, and I'm confident that I can do this again.
Now the next question will be for our presiding commissioners. Kyle, I'll let you go first and then Eddie. As a presiding commissioner, what experience do you have in preparing budgets? Budgets.
Well, being a farmer, I've prepared a lot of cash flow statements and budgets. Matter of fact, I did go up and look at their budget. And I was concerned about the budget. $25 million a year. And of that $25 million, is pretty well left up to the commissioners. They deal with about $3 million. Take care of the courthouse, take care of buying some equipment, and take care of the property. Rest of the budget is pretty well set. All the money that comes in, I'm trying to remember, $12 million goes to the schools, $3 or $4 million go to the Justice Department, and it's pretty well set. And you do have an auditor and a treasurer that oversees that. But yes, the commission is a commissioner, and as Tom Stallings called flag commissioner, but it's quite lengthy. It is huge budget, and it's going to take some time, I'll be quite honest with you, but you just do it. Okay.
Question was, what experience do you have in preparing budgets?
My experience over the years is preparing budgets. Like I said, I'm a business owner for 17, 18 plus years, 20 some, and I was actually a partnership in the business that I purchased. Worked with them then. We had a set of budgets. When you've got, you know, umpteen employees and you've got trucks and you've got machinery and stuff that you got to budget for that coming up in the year, you got to make sure that you had it. I also have to budget my rental houses. I have rental houses. If repairs come in, you know, with the way some of the renters go with it nowadays, you don't know if you got renters in there or what. You don't know if you're going to get rent from them this month. So you've got to prepare for that. You've got to budget that. You can't just go out and borrow money against this house to rebuild it. And if you don't get the money coming in, how are you going to pay tax. You've got to budget that. Best thing to do is if you don't have the money, you don't spend it. Save up. If you've got the money, you got to set money set aside or put back money to be able to fix up these houses. Or if you've got it in any other business, you've got to set money aside in case, you know, like an emergency fund. So if you have a piece of equipment breakdown, you've got the money set back to do that. Not only in a budget like that, we set up, if a lot of y'all know, one of my biggest projects that I did, and it was over several years, was started at the 4-H, Saline County 4-H Shooting Sports Program. We didn't have much budget then. We didn't have any money. When the kids got to the point where we went from 6 kids, and then it jumped up to 30 kids, and then we got 60 kids, we had to find a place to get these kids. So we had to start budgeting, you know, having fundraisers, trying to raise donations and stuff to get the money to get where we need it. Now, through all that planning, budgeting, and watching our P's and Q's, and of course, you know, a lot of people in Saline County have donated money. You know, that program is up. We got 300 some kids sitting there shooting, and we have this, I don't know if anybody's seen it, but we've got a piece of ground out there that we have got all kinds of rooms set up. So my extent of budgeting and planning the budget goes way back, and so far I've been successful at it.
Okay. Now this is for both commissioners, and I'm going to we'll reverse this time. Eddie, I'll let you talk first. The question is, you know, of course, a lot of things have been done in Saline County in the last few years. Bridges, even the courthouse, you know, the citizen passed a proposal there. Do you have a list of items as a potential commissioner that you think that need to be fixed or worked on in the county?
Things worked on, you know, being out talking to people, you know, on this campaign, you know, because everybody hears the complaints and this and that, and honestly, the roads, the bridges, you're always going to have somebody complain about a bridge. The bridges are getting redone, they've got a whole list. You have to take it one at a time. Folks, you got to wait your turn. Gravel roads has always been a main concern. My biggest concern is when people are calling me, why are they piling gravel up on the side of the road? How come we don't have any issues? Why aren't we doing this? You know, they're talking about, we have no crown on these gravel roads anymore. What happened to the crowns? So I've been trying to ask people about, you know, what do you think? I'm not a road contractor. I don't know anything about building a road. I don't know what the grade is. So I've met a few people that actually had worked for the county, operated the equipment. I asked, just point blank asked them, who taught you? Well, the guy that I took their place. Well, who taught him? Well, probably the guy that he took place. Folks, I could probably get on there. I know Kyle could get on the grader, fire it up, run it. Do we know what we're doing? I could grade the road. Am I doing it correctly? Is it at the right grade? I think one of the things I might get initiated in the county is get some education. I know there's classes out there that these people can be trained on how to operate that. And if we're showing, trying to make progress, the people in the county are going to be happy about that instead of complaining because somebody didn't do it the way they thought it should. They've got training, they know what it is, that's fine. Something else that I think we've got, I think we've purchased several high-dollar computer programs, and we're not using it to full capacity. I think it needs to be done. You know, we need to go on and initiate the programs that we've got set. You know, it's kind of silly to spend $100,000 for a program, and we're not using it. That's wasteful spending.
Cut. Question. You have a list of items that you think that need to be fixed in our county?
Well, there's two items I would like for it to be fixed, but I don't know if it would benefit me right now.
That's okay.
Cosmetic. Water fountains, I don't know. They've been there. How long have those water fountains been over there? I was on a country road yesterday going over to another farm, and boy, if I could have gotten a hold of Charles Ray Guthrey, I would strangle him because the road was war stacked. I know that there's primary roads that has to go first. you have secondary roads, and they can't take care of 400 miles. It's got to be on a schedule. Yes, you got a big hole in the road, and you got to fix it. But I'll tell you one thing that's tearing up the bridges is 18-wheelers. Our farm equipment has gotten heavier. The trucks haul 1,200 bushel of grain, and a lot of those bridges, it's been around back in the 50s and 60s, can't handle the weight. One farmer drove his bulldozer across it and broke it down. Well, you know, come on. But yes, we have to take care of the roads. And first of all, I have to talk to the person out there and see what their schedule is. But what I have seen, he does a pretty good job from what I've seen. But that's always going to be a concern. Your gravel roads, you're going to be, that's a everyday job. I don't know if I answered the question or not. Can you tell me one more time? Are you sure? I mean, I can go on and ramble some more, but okay. I mean, you got to fix roads, you got to fix roads. Bridges, courthouse.
Okay, now we'll go back to the, we'll go back to our collector candidates. And we'll start, and this is to Shelly, but I think both candidates, it would be nice for both candidates to respond to it. What changes would you make to the office of collector? Cindy, I'll let you start.
Well, when I get into office, I would like to, if you've read the paper, probably have seen, start escrow accounts. We, from the banking mortgage standpoint, collect escrow accounts for taxes each month. And my idea would be to collect payments from January, automatic payments from January through October, figure tax statements then in October, and mail out statements in November, and then you would have the remainder due. Some questions that you might think of, what if I sold my house in the middle? Well, then of course the title companies would request that, and we would send that to them. I think it would help people manage their money better. And not everyone needs that help, I don't want to say that either, but I know at the end of the year, three kids and Christmas and everything else that goes on, it would be easier for me to be able to do that monthly and make smaller payments. And I think some people, not everyone has to do it, but I think some people might appreciate that. Another thing that I think could save the county money is it's available in the statutes that you can email tax statements. And while I know everyone doesn't do email and doesn't want to do that, the potential there, you could probably save thousands of dollars because mortgage companies would want that and banks would want that and individuals may as well. But in the amount of postage and paper that you could save, I mean, I think those are two things that I would like to explore when I get into office.
Okay. Michelle.
Our software company, Governmentor, every year they are offering more and more updates. It does cost money for updates. That's why the county is limited with what we can update. But however, in reply to Cindy's wanting to offer payments, coupon payments type thing for the county, we already, I don't know, a lot of people know this, but we currently do take payments on a monthly basis if somebody wants to come in and do that. So we do offer that. Not very many people take advantage of that. But we would like to,
That's okay.
I apologize. But
so what changes would you make?
There are no changes really per se right now. The office does flow efficiently. We're just wanting to get updated so that like our taxes online so that people can print out the receipts. It would be with our software that we currently have now to whether or not we can afford to like update, as in Cindy's, what she has said about, but anyway, it all amounts to whether or not we can afford that with the money that we have in our budget, whether or not we can do those changes or not. So.
My daughter had a suggestion that it would be nice where she, when she ran the license office for 8 years, if they had somebody in the office up till 5 o'clock, the same hours as the office, license office, because mm-hmm. people come in from work rushing, then they didn't have everything. Mm-hmm. And it's easier. But I just throwing that out as an idea. Or like I said, that would be a help to the license agent. Okay, then the next we'll go to the commissioner candidates. The next one is kind of on, we were on budgets last, and I'll let Kyle take this first. If revenues decline, what can be done or what can be cut in the budget? Well, we have an increase, the double of the salary of our county prosecutor. Went from $50,000 up to $100,000. I believe the county has to pay for that. You have any ideas if we come short? Kyle, I'll let you, that sounds like a real juicy one.
Yeah, that's a good question. But you know what? We're not gonna raise taxes. No raise taxes. We'll have to find the money. We'll have to go to the office holders. And if, are you saying we run out of money, we can't afford the budget? Read that one more time.
Well, if revenues decline, what can be cut?
And I'm sure revenues decline, because you get a lot from gas tax and sales tax, because that's what I read in the paper. But I'm sure that's built in. I'm sure they have an idea of what they're going to bring. And if the revenues fall, you're just going to have to tighten your belt up. Maybe that my road I was talking about, sorry, we can't handle it this year. You know, that's a good question. I don't mean me blowing smoke or anything, but maybe Eddie can feel better. Go for it.
I know that. Go for it.
You know, if revenue starts declining, you're going to have to make a cut somewhere. You can't wait till we're back in the red. I mean, we're running the black now, and it's good. I know that there's a lot of groups that the county gives donations to and stuff, because they work with us, helped us out on projects. We give them donations. You might have to start cutting down on a lot of that stuff. That's one thing that we start. What I don't like to see is people start talking about we're going to start cutting jobs, cutting people. These people have a job, they have families, you need to keep them there. So if you dig in the budget, you can find all little bitty things, different things that you can start cutting back. And if you take several little things and cut back on, we, you know, won't notice it, but we'll see an increase. You know, you take a lot of little things, it adds up, instead of cutting one big thing out that's going to hurt us in the long run. So as far as that's what I would do. Start in there and look for our little stuff that we don't have to spend, we don't need it, and keep the stuff that we have to have, like employees and benefits and stuff like that.
Pray the economy doesn't.
And pray the economy straightens up.
Yeah.
Okay. Next will be, this will be for our collector candidates, and I'll let Shelly start out on this one. Thanks a lot. Okay. How do you plan to handle the commission on the collection of city taxes? And I believe you all handled the collection of taxes for several of the towns, is that right? I think that's what the question is. The question is, how do you plan to handle the commission on the collection of taxes for the city taxes? Okay.
The commission,
that's the question. How do you plan to handle the commission? I don't know where that go into the county funds or that just.
It does. I mean, we collect it and we turn it over to the treasurer.
The commission does?
Mm-hmm. Well, no, the collector turns the money over to the treasurer. Okay. So so I'm not...
This is referring to the commission that the county collector receives for...
Oh, the
handling,
okay.
For handling those accounts. That's what I'm assuming.
Okay, so bring me the question, I'm sorry.
Okay, how do you plan to handle the commission on collection of city taxes? So the compensation that they pay the county collector, will this go into general revenue? Will you keep it? How do you handle it?
It is an agreement with the cities and the collector on how much they are paid to collect the city taxes for them. So it is the collector's money.
It is, it belongs to the collector. All right, Cindi?
I've been asked this by a couple of the city entities, and I've looked around and talked to some surrounding collectors in area counties, and it's handled differently everywhere. And so the best response I can give, not being in the office right now, is that I do believe it needs to be evaluated and looked at. There's a neighboring county that it all goes back to the commission, and it goes in the budget. I'm sure the office holders probably get a share for the duties that they do, but the bulk of it goes back into the budget. Another county is handled the same way that Shelly described here. So the best answer I can give you is that I think it needs to be evaluated and reviewed, and that's what I'll do when I get in the office.
That's a good question. Okay, okay, this is an interesting one. In the past, this is for our commissioners, in the past, the commissioners have been a good old boys club. Okay? How will you handle that? Go along or stand on your own two feet and go against the grain. Let's see who went. I think you're first. Go for it, Eddie.
Well, all I can say, I'm a good old boy. And I know Kyle is too, but you know, there's some clubs that you just don't want to get into. I'm not one of the good old boys that go along with everything that says. My philosophy is what's right, right, and what's wrong, is wrong. If it's black and white, you got to go with the right. There's not, you know, there's going to be three of us down there. You know, I know none of us are going to agree on everything. If we agree on everything, something's not right. And everything that I've been involved in, when you get a group of people that's making a decision, for one big group, you know, there's discussion, and that's what you gotta have. You're gonna have to have discussions. I don't agree with everything that the other two commissioners agree on. They're not gonna agree with everything that I agree on. You know, it's gonna take 2/3 votes. The thing of it is, you set it out, you discuss it, I'll stand up for my beliefs. I got a strong backbone. I've had to deal with disgruntled customers. I've dealt with disgruntled renters, and if I really believe firmly in something, I'm not going to back down. But like I said, it takes 2/3 votes. Not everybody's going to agree. But if it don't go my way, I mean, people will know that I wasn't going to vote for it. So that's where I stand on that issue.
Okay, Kyle. Good old boys club.
Well, that's a ditto, Eddie. Sounds good. I do know this as being an educator and being on the Board of Education. Every problem that is brought, you've got to look at one side, the other side, and there might be a third side. And you got to figure out which one's blowing smoke and which one's not, and make your decision. If the other two commissioners think it all goes this way and I'm thinking the other way, convince me. Convince me. And then vote your heart. And if you make a mistake, you can correct it. I don't think there's anything that can't be corrected. Okay?
All right. Find out what the membership charge is, right? The old boys club.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, the next one, and I'm not sure, this is for commissioner candidates again. What are your thoughts, what are your thoughts and plans for repairing and restoring our town square falling down and falling down neighborhoods? Well, of course, part of this belongs to our city mayors too. So I'm not sure that it's totally the commissioner's responsibility. I guess the court has it. What are your thoughts about on establishing a Marshall Historic District? Kyle, I'll let you go first. I guess maybe that's the point they're trying to get.
Well, we started with Jim the Wonder Dog. I'm sorry, that was a kind of bullshit show. Historic. Marshall's an old town. We got to preserve it. We don't want to end up like towns like Miami. Should have been another air rock. Of course we need to preserve our square. It's old and it's history. I love seeing the old pictures. Put the horses out there and try to pick out the stores. But like you say, that's got to be in with the city also. So the commission can work with the city government.
And, you have any ideas of what way to work with the city government?
Yeah, whoever writes out a check. It costs money.
Exactly.
And you got to get everybody on board. Some people want to fix up their store, and others can't afford it. So I don't know now. Like Air Rock, it's kind of a cut and dry type of thing. But that's a small town. So, that'd be great. Look at the improvements that they've made in the last 15, 20 years up on this square. So it's still, that's it.
Okay, that's fine.
What?
Well, I think we need to preserve the history of a lot of the old buildings around here and stuff. You know, the Saline County Historical Society, that's one group that we can contact and we work with, as commissioners work with them. And there are a lot of buildings that we need to preserve. A lot of people can't, like I said, can't afford to do it. There's grants that we can get. Work on that. We've got to get people interested in doing that. And I don't know if it's even capable, but a lot of the old train station down here on the railroad tracks. Always thought that would be neat to have it restored as a little museum. That would be great. My wife owns a building up here that used to be the old Catholic Church Rectory. You know, we've done a lot of work to it. It looks great. But, if we contacted the Historical Society, maybe we could have got some other insight on how to, redo it too and preserve it. There's a lot of old homes down over here, and a lot of them are getting kind of run down. It would be awesome if we could have a historical, neighborhood to fix up. And I think it'd be great. We've got to get people on board. We've got to get people to work. Volunteers to work on that. And you know what? When you're a volunteer and you don't get paid for it, it's pretty tough to get people to go out there and bust their hump to do it. But there are a lot of people around who can do it.
And you look at Miami and see how sad it is.
Exactly.
The number of friends in Miami, I remember. Sad story up there. The next question, I guess the last questions I have, the question I have, and this will be to our candidates for collector. This is for Shelly. And Shelly, this question says, you mentioned in your Marshall Democrat News interview that you had 26 years of accounting experience. Where have you worked to gain that experience? And I'll let both of you answer, from what your accounting experience is, okay?
I have, in my years of employment, I first started out working for American Food Management, which was owned by Ron Nielsen. In that capacity, I worked doing payroll. I've done accounts payable and receivables. I've worked at Fitzgibbon Hospital where I've done payroll, accounts payable, and receivables. And from there, I went to the circuit clerk's office where I did receivables. And now I'm in the county collector's office. I do receivables as well. So there's where my years of experience have come from.
Thank you. Cindi.
Accounting
experience, yes.
I don't know that I can call it accounting, but I can tell you what I've done. I've worked from the age of 15. I started as a lifeguard, and from there, started managing people. If you want to get into numbers and paperwork, that would be at the bank. So I have about 10 years experience in banking. I've managed a $32 million deposit portfolio and $11 million loan portfolio. When I left, it was got it as high as $17 million or so in the course of the time I was there. I've collected those funds, my past due list, single-handedly. I handled almost 300 loan files. I serviced those by myself, and I held the lowest number of past due loans of our 17 branches in Western Missouri when we were Equity Bank for 3-4 months in a row. So I don't know if you want to call that accounting experience, $500,000 budget that I helped prepare for the branch that I ran. That's my numbers.
I'm sure that's what the question is meaning. Your accounting experience. That's the last of the questions that I have submitted. I don't know if there's any questions from the floor. I personally appreciate our candidates being here, and I think it's been a really informative meeting, and I appreciate all the people that have shown up tonight. And I think we need to give our candidates a good applause.